Hi, everybody. It's Martha Stewart and her friends. This is my backyard. Actually, it's the back of my driveway where I often do grilling. And because the big weekend is coming up, the 4th of July, Independence Day, I asked Bonnie Saran from, who's my friend, and a fantastic restaurateur. She has five restaurants now?
Yes.
Five restaurants in the neighborhood. Four of them are in Mount Kisco, and one of them's in
Pleasantville.
Yeah, Pleasantville. And Bonnie loves to grill. Of course, she presents Indian food, tandoor food, at her restaurants, and an assortment of other kinds of food. So she's an expert griller in all kinds of different grills, right?
Right. We use the tandoor oven over there at Little Kebab Station, which is like a clay oven.
But and you use a regular grill too.
We use a regular grill too.
Yes.
But most of our kebabs are done in the tandoor oven.
Right. And then we also have Jim Ranieri from the Charles Department Store in Katona. And I have been shopping at the Charles ever since I bought my house here in Bedford. It's a small but very well-stocked department store. Everything from the best sneakers to the very finest in grills. And look what we have here. Charles Department Store, Jim told me, has sold about 1,000 of these green eggs. If you haven't heard about a green egg, listen. If you know about the green egg, also listen, because Jim is an expert and he's going to tell us how to operate the green egg. Everybody's talking about it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it is a nice looking green egg.
It is.
What I really like about it, is, don't get mad at me, is the color. It's so nice. It disappears.
Well,
it could be a hideous green.
I've had a lot of people say, can it come in another color? And I said, no, then it wouldn't be a green egg.
No, of course not. And why is it called a green egg?
Is it
for Dr. Seuss?
No, actually, it's egg, of course, being egg-shaped. And I never really got a chance to ask Ed Fisher about this, why they decided to make it a green color.
Yeah.
But the whole concept behind it is it's a ceramic grill. And what ceramic grills do is they control the temperature and control the moisture in the food.
So when you say ceramic, it's lined.
It's completely ceramic with enamel on the outside.
This is ceramic too.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Okay, excuse me. This is my first day using the green egg.
It's okay.
And I'm very excited.
We're gonna get you up and running.
I usually grill on that grill over there, which was made for me by an Argentine polo player in his spare time when he wasn't playing polo. he did iron work.
Well, you go down to South America and that's all you see is open-faced grills,
yes,
pretty much.
Wood
totally.
Grills.
Yes.
Wood.
Yep.
So I've been doing grilling on that. I'm very excited about grilling in here.
Well, what's sort of nice about this also too, and you know, we're looking at the health issue with this because people are really concerned. I was listening today coming into work about, they're talking about barbecuing, and they're also talking about healthy barbecuing.
Here.
And the concept here is that you shouldn't cook your food too far because the charring is not good for you, the carbonization, and people think just because they have a gas grill that that's gonna solve the problem. But it doesn't at all. And if you're charring up food on a grill, on a gas grill, it's just as bad for you as you're doing on a charcoal. So the concept here is that we have a lot of control. You notice it's closed, I don't have it open.
We're at 500 degrees,
exactly. So when we put the food on the grill here, it's actually going to roast almost at a high temperature, still have the grill marks, but still be very juicy and succulent, but the food will be finished. And you sort of have to have a little trust factor here. I've been cooking on it for about 18 years. I've owned one at home for 15.
I didn't even know they were that old.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they've been around for close to 50 years.
Wow.
And the ceramics...
Where have I been?
The ceramics are made in Mexico at a special plant that they have for the past 50 years. Most all of the things around it are pretty much made here in the United States, except for a few accessories, which is difficult
to compete with. So totally ceramic. Come and look inside.
Yeah.
So this is very heavy. These cannot be ordered. Oh, look, it's like a wonderful tandoor oven, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you know, he was telling me some time ago that these don't crack very easily.
Yeah.
Right.
And unlike the tandoor oven, which cracks very
easily,
it does crack very easily.
It's the formula of the fire brick, and the concept also too, what's really nice about this is they have lifetime guarantee on their ceramics.
The only thing about tandoor is a smaller opening and a bigger body.
And a bigger body.
Exactly.
Yeah,
yes.
So if we put in skewers
inside,
they wouldn't cook the same way.
They won't cook the same way.
Right, because the heat is all in here.
Right.
Yeah, so, But this is beautiful, and we're using organic charcoal, which is very important to
me. It's a mixture of oak and hickory.
Yeah.
And it's basically to green egg specks. There's lots of charcoal that's out there.
I don't want to cool this off too much. Oh, it's way down to...
It'll creep back up.
So the
concept here is that you have a gasket on here with the two pieces, and we have a vent down below, and that's really what controls the heat. I could take this and move this down to, if I'm going to do like a low and slow type of cooking, I could run this down at 220.
Like I want to do, I have a great big rib roast that I'm dying to cook in here.
All right, so what you can do with that is you could do that at about 240,
yeah,
and let it cook for like 6 or 7 hours.
Oh, wouldn't that be cool?
Yeah, it's great. And you don't have to worry about refilling charcoal because it only burns between a half and 3/4 of a pound an hour, which is really pretty cool.
And I have been, I have not been buying a lot of beef because I can't stand the thought of factory farmed beef.
Yeah.
So a friend of mine just started raising and slaughtering his own beef cattle, beautiful Black Angus, up in Brookfield, Connecticut.
Okay.
So I bought a half a cow.
Okay.
And the meat we have today, which is, so we can start talking about the food now because this is hot. This is ready to go, right?
We're ready to go.
Okay.
Yes, we are.
So you'll want to learn a few recipes?
Sure.
Okay.
Absolutely, yeah.
These are new recipes. These are out of our current issue of Martha Stewart Living magazine. And it's my column in the magazine, and I haven't been doing a lot of outdoor cooking, but these burgers are utterly delicious. And these are, it says from Martha's favorite burgers. So I like a lot of things on my burgers. I like a lot of things in the burger. So we're doing a turkey burger. We're doing a hake burger. Hake is a fish, a cold water, delicious fish, something like the codfish, but it's an inexpensive, flaky, white, dense fish. And we are also doing a beautiful aged cheddar and Swiss cheeseburger. And the difference is also the cheeses and the meat.
Yes.
So it makes it really good. So that's right out of the magazine. So here's the beef. That's the beef. It's about, I think he says it's around 90% beef and 10% fat. So it's a high.
Yeah, you
got to
put a little
content.
Bit in there. Totally.
And
yeah.
Notice that this is sitting, if you're going to be doing grilling outside and showing off for your friends, this is sitting in a bowl of ice, a glass bowl for the meat. And did you notice I have a piece of parchment covering the meat and then our trusted crimpable aluminum foil on top. So this keeps our meat icy cold, and I'm sort of frugal, so I sometimes fold this up and use it for the next thing.
I do.
Do you do that too?
Sure, I do. Yeah.
Okay. Good.
Absolutely.
And I'm fine. Now, Bonnie, we have so you grated the whole.
Yes,
is this
I
the
did.
Cheddar or the Swiss?
The Swiss.
Mm. So good. Here, throw that in here, and then we're going to. So we have for 3.5 pounds of beef, we have. 1.5 cups of grated aged cheddar and grated Gruyere or Swiss.
Swiss.
Yeah. And so you want to grate the horseradish from the garden. It's hard to find fresh horseradish everywhere, right?
Right.
But that's okay. This is fine.
I'm going to take some back to the restaurant.
I'm going to give you a few roots here. So grate that into there. Grate a lot. And we're going to mix all these things together. I'll do it with my hands. We need salt and pepper, and put some salt in the meat, pepper in the meat. I like freshly ground black pepper. And doesn't it grate nicely?
Yes.
And we need more than that. So, whatever.
Just
grate it in the bowl.
Okay.
It's easier.
You had a question about where you normally get your meat from.
Well, I just said I get it from my friend. I bought a half a cow. This is my second half a cow. And I have it cut up according to the kinds of things that I like to cook. So I have skirt steak, I have flank steak, I have lots of ground meat because I also feed this very expensive grass-fed meat to my dogs when they're allowed to have meat. And isn't that good? Yes, they like it. And my family is primarily vegetarian. Alexis doesn't eat any meat at all. And the children never have had a hamburger in their lives. So this is for my friends. It's for us. Well, that looks good. Yeah. Doesn't that smell great when it's fresh? You can use prepared horseradish, but I really think using the fresh grated horseradish is so much better. Yeah, you need it for your oysters.
Yes.
Bonnie opened a new restaurant lately. Have you been to her restaurant,
No,
Jim?
I have not yet. I'm
you
going
haven't
to,
been
though.
To any of them?
No, I haven't. Nope.
Oh, they are so fantastic. They're the little kebab station's Indian. The little street of crepes is crepes, but crepes like you've never had before. Great big crepes filled with the most unusual, fabulous assortment of things. So how many crepes do you sell a day?
We sell about 300 to 400 crepes a day.
A day in Mount
Kisco. We sell about 300 to 400 crepes a day. We have a very small place. It's about only 25 seats. But we feed about 300 odd people on a daily basis.
You do. Just in the little street of crepes. Yeah. Then you have the little spice market.
Little spice bazaar, yes.
Spice bazaar.
Yeah, we do all the juices and the smoothies. We have loose teas and spices, and we have a complete lassi bar up over there.
Those lassis are my favorite. I get a lassi every time I go there. And then across the street, if you want to drink, can't drink on any of those
no.
three, right?
Right.
But if you want to drink, you go to the Drunken Chef across the street for the most unusual assortment of food I've ever seen. Really, you have an amazing assortment of food there. We had such a great dinner the other night with Steven, Cyril,
right.
and all Thank his, you. All our friends. We really loved it. Okay, so now we make these into burgers. You want to do burgers?
Yeah.
I don't
we
know.
Have a quick question from Melissa. She would like to know, what do you put on the grill so the burgers don't stick? Do you use oil?
Oh, I brush my grill with safflower oil. So you'll be seeing that. I think we can cook these right on the grill, but I don't like to compress them too much. I like them fat and high. Do you like
yeah.
that? How do you make them?
Yeah. Normally, you know, I don't make these burgers, but I'm learning from you
oh,
right
okay.
now.
Yeah.
yeah.
So yeah. I like a hearty beef. What about
right.
you, Jim? How big do you make them? Do you make them thick or thin?
I make them, you know, in between. I usually do like probably a little bit more than
right?
a third of a pound at a time.
Oh, okay. If I weighed this is probably a half.
Yeah, that's okay.
So I actually have a question from Christopher about flare-ups. How do you prevent flare-ups when you're grilling?
Well, you first of all, you try not to use any of those oils that are in sprayers.
Oh, no, never.
Okay. And you also want to be able to, you're not going to cook with the lid open. That's the whole point. You're cooking with the lid closed all the time. And so how are you going to know if things are ready or done? It's a little trust factor in timing. You know that it's going to be like 4 or 5 minutes on one side on a burger, then you know it might be a minute less on the other side.
Ha ha. But how about the spray bottle for an open grill? I usually use a spray bottle of
you
water.
You have to for an open
water.
Grill. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yep.
So have a like a bottle that your mom used to spray the clothes with before she ironed them. Remember in the days when people used to
iron
their clothes
yeah.
and like iron with, you know, those spray bottles. Do we have a spray bottle ready? I don't know if we do. We should have it. But we have to have that with fresh water in it, not old water. Make sure it's fresh because a little bit might get on your food. But I always have one of those just to tame down the flare-ups. And look how pretty these
and
look.
And what temperature do you cook the burgers in a green egg?
Well, when I cook them, I'm usually pushing it about between 475 to 500 because you want to sear them up pretty well. But what you can do also too is you could start them on one side, then you're going to take them and flip them over. And then from there, you could shut the vent down and just have them go a little bit lower and slower. I did that with lamb burgers the other night and it really worked quite well.
I bet they were so good. Beth Bonnie makes the best lamb burgers and lamb kebabs, but what do you call them in
We got them the lamb chops today. They had
those were I tasted
the
one.
Chops.
I ate two and little lamb chops. Bonnie brought some lamb for cooked in the tandoor oven. Oh, so tasty. So look how pretty these burgers are. So beautiful. This can go away. This is warm water if you want to. It's not completely washing our hands, but we're outside. So have a bowl of water to clean up. And I like to keep my work surface very neat because I don't want people to say I'm a slob. Right?
Yes.
You know, being sloppy. So this could we could use for more hot water here.
Candace would like to know, why do burgers always shrink half their size when cooked?
Well, not all of them do. It depends really on the fat content of your meat and how hot you're cooking them. These should not shrink too much. They will shrink a little bit, but we're going to just leave these right here. It's cool enough. We can just leave those. Let's make the turkey burger.
Yes,
I want you to see the turkey burger. This I invented one day. I went down to Scaglio's, which is our meat market in
yes.
Katona.
Michael, yep,
yep
sure.
The best. And and by the way, here, Bonnie, why don't you mix up a little Russian dressing there? We're making ketchup and mayo and a little bit of salt and pepper. Yeah, a little salt and pepper. And I would squeeze a little lime in it, too. Here's a little lime. You can do that. Just mix that up. And I got some ground turkey meat, and I didn't know what to do with it, so I just invented. And I used a little bit of breadcrumbs. These are the breadcrumbs. And I'm just adding those to the turkey meat. And we have 2 pounds of turkey here. This goes with this. And we have a little bit of red pepper relish to mix in. This is a mixture and we made homemade. You can buy red pepper relish, which is very tasty, but this is a combination of an onion, a little bit of garlic, red pepper, soy sauce, olive oil, and we need salt and pepper. Oh, look at this, it makes my hands all red. And salt and pepper.
And what's that content that you like for both your turkey and your beef burgers?
What's the fat content? Fatless. You know, I don't put any fat in my turkey. This is all dark meat of turkey. No fat. Might have a little bit of natural fat. Did I tell you we have turkeys hatching in my kitchen? Maybe, I wonder if maybe we'll bring them out, the babies. We have 3 babies under a heat lamp right now living in my kitchen counter. Did you see them?
I don't know.
You didn't go in. Oh, they're so cute. And we have peacock eggs in there in the incubator.
Wow.
So I'm trying to raise more peacocks. Those are your, that's your national bird.
Yeah, that is a national bird.
And
yes.
Did you see my peacocks?
I did see them the last time that I was here.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Well, we have white ones now.
Oh, wow.
We have white ones and...
I'm going for a trip after this.
Yes, okay.
After the beer.
So, okay, yeah, we're going to walk around and have a beer. So this is, we need a little bit of Dijon mustard, and we need Worcestershire sauce. Just a little bit of Worcestershire sauce. Yeah, just at least 1 big teaspoon. Yeah, that's good. Oh, I'm going to be red from this. But you see, a lot's going into, and the mayonnaise too. Is the mayonnaise going into here? I don't think so. Huh?
No.
No. And what's this? Oh, I forget what this is. The chili sauce.
Yeah, chili sauce.
Oh, to brush on the outside.
Brush on the
outside. Okay. So now these we're going to make into burgers too. I'll do that so that you don't get dirty. But these, after you mix all the meat up, you make these into goodly sized burgers. These have to chill. And then they chill for at least an hour. And we have some pre-chilled in the fridge. So you see, those are very nice looking turkey burgers. I bet you've never tasted anything quite as good as this turkey burger. So that's going to go back into the kitchen. And we can bring out the ones that were already made. And I will rinse my hands. Oh, it comes off. No, it's not like that. I didn't think it was going to come off. Here, Judy. There they are. And those are going to get brushed with chili. This is chili sauce.
So Kristen would like to know, should you push in the center of the meat before putting the patties on the grill?
I don't, but you can. But one thing I do not recommend is squishing the meat. You know how men stand there grilling, squishing, pushing the spatula on the meat, constantly pushing, making them as thin as they possibly can. I don't get it. It's, you know what it is? They just love to stand there. That's what it is. Jim, do you push down on your
meat? No, I don't. It's against my religion.
Oh, excellent. Well, I'm glad to hear that.
Yeah.
So this is
just watch.
More taste on our turkey burger. So pretty soon we're getting ready to put some stuff on the grill, but not yet, because I want to show you the hake burger. So these are all ready to go.
Let me start making these a little drunken chef.
You sure?
Yeah, because we don't have burgers. We have the sliders, the lamb sliders, and I want to do.
Yeah, you can do these.
Oh,
okay, so here's our. Yeah. Why isn't it cut up?
Good call to cut it up. We used the turkey slider. Right.
What's that?
Turkey slider.
Yeah. I want to do the burger. So we don't have the burger right now, but
Okay, so now here's our hake. Hake is a beautiful fish, and if you get these, this is like a half of a hake, and you have to cut it by hand, and it should be almost frozen. This is not almost frozen, but it should be. It should be very, very cold. And you want to take out this, Eric Repair calls this the blood. It's really just the dark meat of the fish. I don't like to put that into my burger. And you cut this up. But if you're going to, I was just recently gifted Bonnie a 40-pound halibut.
Wow.
When I went to Maine, I get there with 10 people for the weekend, and I had my menus all set up pretty much of what I was going to cook. And there sitting on my kitchen table is a fresh caught 40-pound halibut.
Wow.
Entire halibut, head on, everything on. And I thought, oh God, I had to wrestle with that fish for the entire 3-day weekend. That's Memorial Day. And I used it all. I didn't want to waste any of it. So I made halibut burgers. I made halibut chowder. I made halibut steaks. I made halibut collar, like the Japanese. Mm-hmm. We did everything imaginable with the halibut. Oh, this is nice. See, this cuts up very nicely because it's a very... Oh, you have one done.
Well, you can add to that.
Oh, you want me to add it? Oh, okay. It's no fun to watch chopping, but if you are going to deal with a fish like this, you really have to cut it all up like this. And the extra, guess who's getting the extra?
The dogs. The dogs, yes.
My dogs are the best fed dogs in the wide world. We're going to boil this up, and they're going to have halibut. Here, I have enough in the bowl. Can somebody take this?
Thank you.
So now we'll add all the other ingredients. So we add mayonnaise to the mix. We add 2 eggs, nicely beaten up with a fork. Oh, and don't go away because you're gonna see my favorite corn recipe too. Yesterday I went to Lancaster, Pennsylvania. We flew down in the morning. It takes a half an hour from Westchester Airport to fly to Lancaster, which is Amish country. It's so beautiful there. I haven't seen more beautiful farms anywhere. And have you ever been?
I haven't been.
Oh my gosh, Bonnie.
You have to take me next time.
Oh, it's so beautiful. And so this we can stir up. But you need the egg for binding and the mayo for binding. And breadcrumbs too. You need breadcrumbs, so we'll add those. So you can stir that. You need...
Can I ask you a question?
Sure, absolutely.
So
yeah.
People are asking about where you find organic
corn. Well, there's a lot of different places you can get it. I mean, the Big Green Egg does have their own charcoal they have made up for them. That is all natural hardwood. And really, it's really hard to say that it's organic as much as it would be as just natural wood. And that's what I would sort of consider more like. Natural wood is more of an acceptable, but they're actually growing the trees to make the charcoal. There's a few plants here in the United States as well, as you're starting to see some of the charcoal come out of Canada as well. So we carry both at our store.
And look at the mix. So I added capers, the breadcrumbs, the egg, the mayo. This makes such a beautiful mix. Does it sound good?
Sounds great.
Bonnie's gonna be serving these at, oh good. And then the chives, fresh chives right from my garden. This is the easiest way to chop chives, is cut them with scissors that are specifically for kitchen use, food use.
So Stacy wants to know, so you can actually cook mayo?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Oh gosh, mayo is like the thing, so many people add mayo to everything. They do it for their chicken glazes, they do it for, what do you use mayo for?
We use it for a lot of our dipping sauces, yeah. Even the open face sandwiches that we just introduced.
Those are
remoulade up with that.
Oh, I had a smoked salmon one today.
Did you like it?
Oh, great. But you know what I like? Because you're using whole wheat bread.
Yes.
Oh, we should put some of those corns on the grill too. Okay, so the hake, this is it basically. And don't forget to add a goodly amount of salt and pepper to your hake. Stir that up, Bon. Okay, so we're gonna put the corn on the grill. Wanna come on over here? This is my Argentine grill. And we're just gonna put the corn. Notice this, the husk has been pulled back. We have a pan heating, don't touch the pan. My favorite cast iron pan is heating, and it is going to be ready to cook the hake burgers. A hake is so delicate, you have to cook it in a pan. So be aware of that.
And Michael wanted to know, what other fish or seafood could you use to make these types of burgers?
What other fish? Anything? Codfish, halibut, salmon. Salmon burgers are delicious. So tent the burgers and we're going to be using our trusted lightweight Reynolds wrap. You don't have to use the real heavyweight for this. So I think we should put at least four of the beef burgers. And four of these on the
on the grill.
Great.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
And we should tent them with this.
Okay.
Yep. You want to put them on?
Sure.
Yeah. Come around. Oh, don't forget. Brush the grill.
Yep.
Brush the grill.
Tend to get a little flame out of that, but that'll go away.
Okay. Yep. So here. One. Two. Oh, these look so good. Three. Four. I'll do five. I'll do six.
There you go.
So, beef on one side.
Yep.
And we'll do these turkey burgers. They're very soft. Is that okay? They're very soft. I don't have a spatula for this, so not really. No. I'm going to have to get those colder. Okay, you can close that.
Okay, great.
Okay, so now I want to brush a little bit of olive oil on my corn. Turkey is very soft. I can't get it on the grill. Just stick it in the freezer for a second, okay?
So Lynn wanted to know, why do you pull the husks back for the corn?
Instead of cooking it in the husk? Look how nice and easy. You just pick it up off the grill and eat it. Otherwise, it's hot. You have to peel it back. You have all that silk to deal with. It makes a big mess all over your table. You might as well grill it just open like that. It's so nice. Bonnie, you hold those.
Yes. I'm going to brush the corn.
Oh, it's already cooking. This was the first corn of the season in Lancaster. Who knew that in Pennsylvania you'd get corn at this time? It's not even July and they have corn. So you can put... salt on them, yeah. Oh, it's so beautiful. Isn't that great looking corn?
And Amanda wanted to know, do you soak the corn with husks in water prior to grilling?
I didn't. These are so fresh, I didn't bother. Yeah, just do it all. I didn't do that, so you could. But these are going to cook up. Look, they're already cooking. They're already getting a nice little color. But you could do that. And I think I got 16 ears of corn. So inexpensive there too, compared to the North Fork or the South Fork of Long Island. Okay. So now the burgers, the hake burgers are chilled. Look how great those look. I have to put a little bit of olive oil in the pan. Don't touch the handle of the pan. But I'm not. Now I'm going to put a little olive oil. Look, it's so hot. That's the way to cook.
Not a minute.
I don't need it quite yet.
Okay.
So here we have chilled hake burgers. These are almost like giant crab cakes.
Yeah.
Aren't they?
Delicious.
And they're much cheaper than crab cakes. Uh-oh. I could have just done two, but... I need a little thin spatula.
Oh, the dog.
And these fish should go back in the fridge. I'm only going to cook three. Here, take a picture of the doggies.
Yeah.
The doggies have come. That's GK, Genghis Khan, and Creme Brulee, and Bete Noir. Where the heck is our other friend? Where's Francesca? Hey guys. Oh, they want something. What do you want, GK? I have no utensils.
She's good.
No utensils. Okay. Do we ever look at those?
We did. Bonnie
and
I did.
Oh. Yeah. And what'd you think? Oh, look.
Look at this.
Okay, look. We don't need this here. We need this over here.
And see how the moisture's coming right up to the top there. It's great. Yeah. Yeah, it's perfect.
And then I'm going to get one of these.
Yeah. When you're ready. Yeah. I think we can almost.
And what's the temperature on the grill right now?
We're cooking about 500. Yeah. Yep.
And how long do these?
Well, these have been in about 5 minutes so far. So I'm thinking we're probably going to go. Maybe, yeah, I think we're ready to flip these over. Yeah, definitely. So. They're pretty easy to flip over here.
Lonnie, you're going to make this corn too, like you said. You have work
waiting
to do.
Patiently for the beer.
Jean wanted to know what a nice dessert would be with this type of barbecue.
Oh, there's only one for the 4th of July, strawberry raspberry shortcake. That's the only one. I wouldn't have anything else, would you?
Well, you could do one more thing. You could grill pineapple on the egg after you get done making your burgers.
Yeah. Not for me. Okay, now these are brioche buns from Eli Zabar, I think, or Balthazar. Who are these? Eli. Eli got really smart, I don't know when, probably about 30 years ago, and he makes the most delicious things. So his brioche buns, you're never going to buy those other buns again. And you can actually order them online if you have to. E-H-E, Eli Zabar. I'm gonna plug him because these are really good. Okay, Bonnie, you're gonna hold this, and I am going to find a brush if I can. And we're going to butter these. You have to butter them. And these get really, they're so tender. Brioche is a dough that's made with egg and milk. Mm-hmm. And they get, they cook really fast, so you have to watch them. But isn't that a nice way to cook a fish burger? Right on the grill? Isn't that great? Yeah. Are you going to really put, are you going to call it Martha's Hake Burger?
Yes, I am.
Okay, you have to put Martha on there.
Yes, I am.
And I'm not going to, you have to.
I will. Can I?
It's a copyrighted recipe.
Okay.
No, you don't have to, but you should.
Yes.
You'll sell lots of them. Oh boy, this is so good. And
does it matter if you're using salted butter or any kind of
I use unsalted butter. So beautiful. Ooh, the Hake burgers look like they need to be turned. Okay, that's gonna stay here. Oh, look at that. Oh. Mm-hmm. So beautiful. And that's olive oil I'm using. I could have been neater than that, but it doesn't matter.
People are asking about the buns again, if you want to tell them where they came from.
Eli Zabar. E-H-E. Oh, look, see? You have to get them right off. You do not want to burn them. So perfect. Here. The ones that are covered are done. Yeah. Where's the top to that one? Oh, okay. And our corn is getting done. The whole thing about grilling is You want to be everything to come off the grill at the same time, and it's really hard. It's really hard. But you should also tell people corn's coming later. It takes a little longer, but I'm going to show you one corn at least and how good it is. Oh, it's already getting juicy. So we started this fire with apple wood kindling and then natural charcoal. No fire starters allowed. We don't do that. Okay, go see how the hamburgers are.
Yeah, that sounds like a roast too. Yeah. Yeah, well, the thicker ones are interesting. This is great. Yeah, sure. Yeah, we love them. Perfect.
So this is the log size.
This is the large size. You notice, right? I have the vent open here. This doesn't make a lot of difference of how things are cooked with it. Right. It's all about down below here.
Right.
So to keep it from getting really super smoky in there.
I can put these on now.
Yeah. Let me move these other ones around.
Oh, did you move them?
I did. I moved them into the middle. Yeah, because I wanted them to cook a little bit. I think these are almost ready to come out here.
Oh, they are ready.
Yeah.
Look.
Yeah.
I wouldn't want them done any more than that. See, they are, each piece is on a piece of parchment, so easy to lift. And
someone was asking earlier why you put them back in the fridge.
They were a little soft, and I didn't want to lose their shape. That's why. I'm not hiding them from you. And I'm putting the side down with the chili sauce on, so that it cooks into the. Yeah, I think that's enough for now.
Yeah. I always find that a problem with the turkey burgers. It's hard to be able to get them to stay where you want them to, you know, when you're picking them up.
Okay, so we have a few guests here. These burgers, they can sit for a minute or two. You don't want them to sit too long, and you want them to be put on a beautifully grilled bun. That is a beautifully grilled bun in my mind. I'm gonna take, this one's the most beautiful. Goes right on there. And you have to have, there's no utensils here. Mm-hmm. And this could have some Russian dressing. It could have, I think it could have some pickles. It could have a nice slice of tomato. And it could have some, oh, I love this too. No, that it's all mixed up here, so you have to pick and choose, but we have specific things that really just go with this burger. I think that looks...
Oh, it looks delicious.
Really good. Somebody's lucky going to get that one. And now, does that look good to you, Jim?
I haven't gotten that close yet.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
Jim's going to eat that.
And now I'll show you how to make the corn, because you have to see that. No, I just need a plate for the corn. Mm-hmm. I have my cheese. I think the Hake burgers.
I'm gonna take these to the restaurant.
Yes. Okay, so here we have our corn. Now, secret ingredient, you'll never believe this, sour cream. Brush the whole ear of corn with sour cream. This is our take on the Mexican corn, which they, you know, they put, they put a beautiful white cheese on it. And this is feta cheese. Just really press the feta cheese into it like that. Not quite dry enough, but that's it. And salt and pepper. And somebody took the cayenne pepper away, but a little cayenne pepper and a wedge of lime. And that's how you eat corn this year. Every year it's different. And the Hake burgers.
Here we have
a Hake burger right here, guys. So let's put some kale, fresh kale, just chiffonaded, a pickled red onion, a beautiful, I'm going to use some more of this lovely, fragrant, delicious, it's kind of a Russian dressing, and some watercress. And that's your hake burger. Remember, you have capers in there, you have Worcestershire, you have a very healthy vegetarian, pescatarian option. So that's that one. Oh, here's another one. This is my favorite. And crumbling. That tastes so good, Bonnie.
And this is mine.
Okay, that's
with the chilled beer.
Okay, I'm going to put some pepper relish on this one. More of the kale, tomato, water. Oh, the red onion is very important, I think. Is that a wasabi mayonnaise?
A Dijonaise.
Okay, so it's not using wasabi mayonnaise, but Dijon mustard. And then this is that one. That is fantastic. Okay, that's
Ravuna
that one.
Is asking, you can remind her how you made the Russian dressing.
Ketchup, mayo, a little bit of lime, shoyu. So easy. We have another, we have the burgers. The other one's coming.
Okay, you want to give a shot of this?
Yes.
There you go. Nice grill marks on. Moisture's coming up good. Yeah, look at this.
This is the perfect grill for this.
Tony, it's great.
This is turkey. Now you have to cook it enough because it's important. I forgot which is the dressing that we're going to use on the turkey burgers.
Chili mayo.
Oh, can I have that? None of it was marked, so I didn't know what it was. Thank you. Chili mayo. So this has chili sauce in it with mayo. And you can always add lemon to it. It's always good. But you know the chili sauce that you buy in the store, Heinz chili sauce. It's very good. And looking good. Maybe one of those.
I think so.
I think it's done. Yeah.
They look
done.
Close.
They look
good. Look
well. Yeah. Oh, I will have some pepper relish. Yeah. Oh, you do it.
Okay. I always
you have
put
to
the
go
grain
that
in the front.
Way. That's
exactly.
Right. Right here. You always. A fork would be good.
Yep.
Yeah, that's good.
There you go. Right there.
Right there.
Perfect. Yeah. Okay.
And don't forget this amazing relish. It's in the burger and it's out of the burger. That is so pretty. You're gonna love this turkey burger better than any turkey burger you have ever tasted. And, oh, you could also put guacamole on it, but we have a secret for guacamole, too. Here, why don't you take that one? That's a good one for you. Don't overcook those.
I'm going to take them off right now.
Yeah. So here we have a nice homemade guacamole, but I need a spoon. Here's a spoon. This is just avocado, lime, onion, jalapeno pepper, and cilantro. Now, my friend and weekend housekeeper Emma taught me to hard boil some eggs. So we hard boiled some eggs and she adds hard boiled eggs, so you're getting a protein in your guacamole. And I must say, people love it. They love it. And you can just chop your egg coarsely. And nobody really knows it's egg in there. They just look at it and they think, God, this is so good. But you are getting a very nice protein. So you can make this as part of your salad, no problem. And don't overcook your eggs. These are perfectly cooked hard-boiled eggs, and you know how to do that, right? See how the center is a little moist? Put the eggs in a pot, cover them with cold water, bring them to a boil, turn off the flame, cover the pot, put your timer on for, depending on the size of the egg, but for extra large eggs it's 13 minutes. You could set it from, most eggs are about 10 minutes. So they're not cooking, they're sitting. There you have the most beautiful guacamole. And yes?
Sorry, Michelle wants to know, what's the best way to clean the grill, or how do you like to clean the grill?
We're not there yet, Michelle. Oh. Gosh.
She's jumping ahead.
She's jumping ahead. Let me taste this. Bonnie, you want a little taste?
Yes.
You want your beer now?
Yes, I'm waiting.
Mmm. Needs salt, needs pepper. Don't forget to salt and pepper your guacamole. And I don't taste enough cilantro in here either.
No.
But what do you think? Mmm. And a little more lime juice. Everything should be as highly seasoned, carefully highly seasoned, as you can make it. And people will adore you. Mmm, I have to taste that. I just want to tell you what it's like. Oh, here's a fork.
Those look great.
These are very, very nice. Look, well cooked. I mean, I think perfectly cooked.
Yeah. And how long did they look nice and juicy too.
They cooked for approximately, 10 minutes?
Yeah, a little under 10. Yeah. Well, you have to remember also too, what's nice about this is you have a lot of control over the environment in the grill. So it's a little different than an open grill.
I forgot to tell you what these are really called. They're not called turkey burgers. They're called turkey meatloaf burgers because they do taste like turkey meatloaf. That is so good. You want one?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
Which one do you want?
I might go for the
beef
fish
burger?
One. Yeah, I might try a little taste of the
okay.
fish yeah, in a minute. Yep.
He doesn't want a turkey burger.
The lunch was so good. Yeah.
This is a lot of fun. Oh, and I forgot to show you another thing that we've used our Reynolds wrap with. These are onions that I found. Come close. You have to come very close. These are giant onions. They're called sugar onions, and they are available at this time of year in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. They're growing in the fields. These were wrapped in parchment paper and then in aluminum foil. You couldn't do it without aluminum foil. Tightly sealed, put on the green egg for 1 hour. And you just eat these with salt and pepper. And one of the best first courses, you can drizzle a little bit of vinegar over them or a little bit of olive oil over them. Just a little bit, and you have one of the best first courses you have ever tasted. Those are spectacular. Again, you couldn't do it without the Reynolds wrap. Very nice. So, any other questions?
Yes, we did. Amanda wants to know, did you make your own tortilla chips?
Of course. And those, I just cut up real good tortillas, corn tortillas. I brush them with olive oil, put them in the oven, with lots of salt, and crisp them up. That's it. But and hopefully you have a friend like Emma who makes your own tortillas for you. You know, ask your friends what they make. If they come from another country, I guarantee they make something totally delicious that you should be making. Emma makes also really good tamales. One day we'll do a tamale lesson. And her tamales, vegetarian tamales, are so superb. I served them for breakfast the other day here at the farm, and everybody loved them. They were just filled with peppers, different kinds of peppers. So there's another onion. I need two more plates, please. Thank you.
Jean wants to know, what are some of your other favorite veggies to grill?
My favorite veggies. I like grilled tomatoes. I like grilled potatoes. I like grilled squash. Squash is delicious. Cut it lengthwise, like zucchinis, and quite thick, not too thin. A lot of olive oil and salt and pepper. Everybody's coming up for burgers. Come in for burgers, guys? Okay, grill those, buns. All the guys who work on the farm are coming for burgers. Come on, guys. Oh, good. What do you want? Are these soft enough, I hope? I think they are. Look at these grilled onions, guys. Salt and pepper. Doesn't that look good?
Right.
I'm teaching Bonnie something. She's gonna.
Yes, I'm gonna take these Dawa.
Now Dawa works at where?
Little kebab station.
At the kebab
too.
Station.
Yes.
He works at the kebab station. He makes the best is, well, I call it quesadilla, but it's paratha,
the
right?
Paratha,
he makes
yes.
all the breads, Indian yes. breads.
It's
really
great.
Good.
It's awesome.
Okay, so I think we better put a few more of these hamburgers on, guys.
Slowly.
Look at these, and you have your salmon burgers here. I mean, here's a nice burger. Here, put the rest on those. Put those. Here, who wants a? This is a turkey burger. These are really good. Anybody want one? Want a turkey burger?
Okay.
This is very tasty, and you can put lettuce and tomato on it too.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. And here's one. There's another turkey burger.
Okay,
you have to bring a roll. And take those burgers on the table too. They're all dressed up. Here, put this.
He's gonna get.
Oh, those I did on the Today Show the other day. Oh, if you weren't watching the Today Show, what's going on? There's the cutest. It's store-bought stools, and we stenciled the pattern using Martha Stewart craft paint on the canvas, and they're very cute. I think Charles Department Store should sell those.
Those are very nice. I like those.
I made those. Yeah.
Very nice. I'm impressed.
Yep. Here's a turkey burger.
Okay.
You want a turkey burger?
Yes. Put more people at the table that way also too, which is good.
Yeah. What?
You can put more people at the table.
Yeah. Here, there's another turkey burger, and then beef burgers are coming, guys. So all these.
I'm on turkey meatloaf burger. Can I call it the turkey meatloaf burger?
Of course. Isn't it great?
Yeah.
It's a cute name. Everybody, you know, my kitchen thought I was crazy.
Okay, thank you.
That's that. I'm here. I'll take the bowl. Here, shake.
Where can you normally buy blank spoons? Do you see where you can buy them?
Judy, where did we get the stools?
Buyer, B-Y-E-R
of Maine for the plain stools. And then you can they're easily, you have to assemble them anyway, so you can paint the canvas. And did you show them up close? I think they're really cute. I have to taste the corn myself.
We have one last question. George wants to know, what is coming out of your
this
garden
This is
now?
The best corn ever. I love this corn. Sour cream, sour feta cheese, cayenne pepper, and lime juice. Oh, what do you think?
Delicious.
Isn't it?
With
you
beer.
Got a beer. I want a beer. I have to pack. I'm going on a very fabulous trip on tomorrow morning at 3 a.m. to the Pacific Ocean to the Galapagos.
Oh, wow.
So we can't do Facebook Live from the Galapagos because they don't have any Wi-Fi. But I will be doing blogs, so you must look at my blogs. In 2 weeks, there will be amazing blogs of all the things. I have underwater cameras.
Really?
I have wetsuits. I have everything I need. And I'm taking the family, so we're going to have a great time. And all of you, I just want to wish you all. And Jim, come here. Thank you for helping us so much.
Thank you, Martha. It was really great.
If you need a green egg, you go to Charles Department Store, Katona, New York, 10536.
And if I, it's charlesdeptstore.com.
Deptstore.com.
Great, thank you.
And if you need Reynolds wrap, you know where to get that. And if you want to eat good food, the best food in the neighborhood, you go to Bonnie's Restaurants, Little Kebab Station, the Little Crepe Street, and the Little Spice Bazaar, and the Drunken Chef. And if you want the best magazine in the whole wide world, you read Martha Stewart Living for all these recipes. And if you drink beer, Porter.
Porter.
Is that mine?
I got two rolls.
Is that mine?
That's from Michigan.
No, thanks. I'm good. Thank you.
Beer.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yes.
Happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th of July.
It's a very important holiday. Things are happening that are not so good all over the world, and we have to celebrate the good of America this 4th of July. So happy 4th of July, everybody.
Cheers.